Good morning, myself Santosh Bharti. Now I am going to discuss about the choppers. Choppers is basically DC to DC converter. Now last lectures I discussed about the buck chopper and boost chopper. Buck chopper is also known as the step down chopper or down converter, while boost converter is the step up converter. Right? Now today I am going to discuss about the buck boost converter. So basically buck boost converter. So this is the boost converter, step up converter. In step up converter I discuss the basic circuit analysis, waveform analysis and the derivation related to DC voltage, DC current, AC voltage, AC current, output voltage, all that. And mode of operation, steady state operation, continuous current mode operation. Now today I am going to discuss about the buck boost converter, right? In buck boost converter is a type of DC to DC converter that has an output voltage magnitude that is either greater than or equals to the input voltage magnitude. Yeah, other converter, in buck converter or boost converter, the output voltage is always less than the input voltage. In boost converter, the output voltage is greater than the boost converter. But in these cases, the output voltage is either greater than or equal to the input voltage magnitude. It is equivalent to the flyback converter using a single inductor instead of the transformer. So basically, this is the difference. This is the moderation of the step down converter and the step up converter. Now, it converts the DC voltage in between the step down and step up converter. Yeah, the application of buck boost converter is basically using the small wind turbine charging a battery bank. Okay, so this is the circuit analysis or circuit diagram of the buck boost converter. Yeah, this is the switch. We are applying the control pulses. These are the control pulses. Control pulses. This is the inductor, this is the freewheeling diode, this is the capacitor and this is the load resistance. Yeah? So there are two cases. This is the case when switch is on. This case is when switch is on, and this is the case where the switch is open. Basically this one. This is the switch is open. Clear? You can see when switch is on, it acts as a short circuit and the diode goes in the reverse bias. The diode goes in reverse bias, act as an open circuit. Here you can see the open circuit. And here when switch is open, now diode goes in the forward bias. This is the forward bias, diode is a reverse bias. In reverse bias act as an open circuit, in forward bias act as a short circuit. Then we have to calculate the voltage across the inductor and output voltage. And in these cases also calculate the voltage across the inductor and output voltage. So this is the circuit analysis of the buck boost converter. Right? Clear? So now the mathematical analysis is basically when switch is closed. For these cases, now you can see from this diagram, which when switch is closed, this out, the source voltage are not connected with the output terminal. Here, in parallelly the voltage across the inductor. So mathematical analysis, when switch is closed, now the inductor voltage is equals to, you can see here, for these cases, when switch is closed, now this is the output terminal is not connected with the input terminal. Now this voltage across the inductor equals to source voltage. Clear? Then inductor voltage. VL equals to VS. VL equals to VS, where we know that the how to calculate the voltage across the inductor. This is equals to L d I L by d t. This is equation number one. Clear? Similarly, how to calculate now d I L by d t equals to V L by L. V L is V S. That is the V S by L. Clear? This is the equation number five. Two. This is the equation number two. Similarly, how to calculate the, now we can put here from the this waveform, this is the graphical waveform, you can see we have to calculate the current ripple I. This is the basically from here, this is the on time. This is the on time from here to here. So we have to calculate now this delta IL. This delta IL up to on time at this point. At this point. Total time is, this is the total time, on time plus off time. This is the off time. Clear? So we have to calculate basically this current, this IL current. Now we know that we can write this delta IL. So d IL by dt, we can put this the delta IL upon delta t. Clear? Or we can write this is the delta IL upon t on time, t on time. Clear? T on time is this time. This is the t on time. This is equals to delta t on this value. Clear? How to calculate average current? Average current, basically this is equals to, we can put this is the delta I L upon t on. T on is the d into t. How to calculate TR? TR, total time. T on plus T off equals to total time. Where T on is? T on upon total time equals to duty cycle. So T on equals to duty cycle into total time. Total time. How to calculate T off? T off is 1 minus D into total time, the t of time. So substitute this value here. Clear? So this is delta I L upon dt equals to V S by L. Where delta I L equals to V S by L into duty cycle into time. This time is known as, this is the current ripple when switch is closed. Current ripple when switch is closed. Clear? Similarly, find the analysis, second analysis, when switch is open. When switch is open, now from this circuit you can see. When switch is open, you can see here the output voltage is at this terminal. This is the Vs minus V0 upon Vl. When switch is open, the output voltage is this terminal is V0, this terminal is VL, the output voltage. Okay, second, when switch is closed, open. When switch is open, now you can see here. When switch is open, this terminal is open from this. We have to calculate the output voltage from this terminal. Clear? So next slide you can see here. So this is the from this circuit. This is the switch is open. For open cases, now this is the separated from this terminal. So we have to calculate like this. So this inductor voltage from here, switch is open. Now inductor voltage VL equals to V0. V0 means at this at terminal this is the VL and at this terminal this is the V0. So VL minus V0 equals to 0. When you apply the KVL, applying the KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law. Now VL minus V0 equals to 0, that is VL equals to V0. Here where we know that VL is L into D I L upon dt. Clear? So D I L upon dt equals to VL by L. VL is V0, that is the V0 by L. Now we know that, so this is equation number 3. Now we know that, now this T I L by dt equals to delta I L upon delta t, or this is the delta I L upon t of time. T of time. T of time, we know that this is the delta I L upon 1 minus t upon total time period. Okay? So substitute this value here. So you will get this delta I L upon 1 minus d into t of time, this is equals to V0 by L. Or delta I L equals to V0 by L into 1 minus d upon total time period. This time is known as, this is the current revealed when switch is open. This is the current revealed when switch is open. Clear? Clear? So this is suppose equation number 4. This is equation number 4. Now we have to calculate. So you can see from this, this is the 1 minus d into t V0 by L is the same. When switch is open, before that, now this is the Vs dt upon L when switch is closed. Clear? Clear? So this is the load current, this is the load voltage, and this is the source current, I mean Is. Source current. How to calculate the average source current? So next slide, I'm going to discuss about the output voltage. Output voltage. Here, in steady state condition, in steady state conditions, you can see from here, in steady state operation, now delta IL closed plus delta IL open equals to 0. Clear? Now current repeal in the switch on mode plus current repeat in the switch off mode, the sum of these two is equal to 0. So when you are substituting here, so this is delta I L closed plus delta I L open equals to 0, where delta I L is the V S d t upon L plus V naught 1 minus d into t upon L equals to 0. So this is equals to Vs dt upon L plus V naught t by L minus minus V naught t by L equals to 0. I L equals to 0, now we can put here dt take common. So this is Vs minus V0 by L equals to minus V0 t by L. This L is cancelled and this t is cancelled. This t is cancelled. Then V0 equals to so Vs d minus V0 d equals to V0. Here, so Vs d equals to V0 take common. This is 1 plus d, where V0 equals to Vs d upon 1 plus d. This is wrong. Minus Vs. This is the minus. Yeah. When you solve this equation, when you solve this equation, you will find now this V0 equals to minus Vs d upon 1 minus d. This is the output voltage for the steady state case. In steady state cases, the current will be in the switch on mode and current will in the switch off mode are equal to 0. Summation of these two current equals to 0. When you put this condition, and you will find the output voltage is equal to minus Vs d upon 1 minus d, where d is the duty cycle. Duty cycle upon 1 minus duty cycle, this is equal to 0. Now you can find the same here. Note the output of buck boost converter either be higher or be lower than the input. Yeah? Clear? You can see if you are taking the duty cycle is 50%, 0.5, you will get the output voltage is less than input voltage. Right? So it depends upon the duty cycle. If duty cycle is greater than 50%, the output is higher than the input signal. For D equals to 50%, now this output voltage is greater than the input voltage. Clear? For D less than 50%, this V naught is less than Vs. Output is lower than the input signal. The output voltage is always negative because here the minus of the source voltage. The output voltage is always negative. Yeah? No, the output voltage is never directly connected to the load. Yeah? The output of source load is never directly connected to load. First of all, we have to calculate the duty cycle. Energy is stored in inductor when switch is closed and transferred to the load when switch is open. Clear? Clear? The output does not directly connect to the load. How to connect? First of all, in the switch on mode, when switch is closed, now energy is stored in the inductor. And when switch is open, now this stored energy is transferred from inductor to load. So this is the procedure. That's why it is called the buck boost converter. Because in buck boost converter, the load is not directly connected to source. Clear? In simple mode, you can say when in switched on mode, now energy transferred to the inductor, and switched off mode, from inductor, energy transferred to the load mode. Clear? So this is the basically the output voltage. Now next, calculate the average inductor current. Average inductor current. In the average inductor current, graphically you can find, assuming no power loss in the converter, power absorbed by the load must equal to the power supplied by the load. Yeah? That is power absorbed by the load must be equal to power supplied by the source. Clear? Power absorbed by the load, that is the P naught, equals to power supplied by the source, that is the PS. PS, how to calculate PS? This is the source voltage into the source current, that is the PS. How to calculate the power? That is the V naught squared by R. Clear? Clear. But average source current is related to the average inductor current. Clear? But the average IS is directly related to the IL into duty cycle. IL into duty cycle. Substitute this value here. So you will get this is the VS into IL into duty cycle. Clear? Substituting the value of V naught here. V naught is how much? V naught equals to, that is, from above equation, V naught equals to minus Vs into D upon 1 minus T. Substitute this value here. You will get the Vs square. Here, substitute this value. So I will get here IL equals to, we have to calculate basically this average current. So IL is the, from here IL equals to V naught square by R upon Vs into duty cycle. Vs into duty cycle, right? Clear? Yeah? Yeah. Now we can put this is the P naught B, B square upon that is the P naught upon Vs into duty cycle. Clear? So substitute value, this is the V naught equals to this. So V naught equals to minus Vs D upon 1 minus D whole square, finish square, V naught square upon R into Vs into D. From here, it will come Vs into duty cycle upon R 1 minus duty cycle whole square. This is the average inductor current. This is IL. This is average inductor current. Clear? This is the average inductor current. From which we can calculate this formula. Now I am going to discuss about the value of L and C. Clear? So from the figure, from this figure, how to calculate the average inductor current? Value of L and C. Have to calculate the this is the average inductor current. We have to calculate the maximum inductor current. This I max equals to IL plus delta IL by 2. Delta IL by 2. So substitute this value. Now you will find IL. IL is the Vs upon R 1 minus duty cycle whole square plus delta IL. Delta IL by 2 means this is the this is equal to IL plus delta IL closed by 2. So delta IL closed is the Vs into duty cycle by L into 1 by 2. Clear? So this is the maximum inductor current. Similarly, minimum inductor current. This is equal to average inductor current minus delta I by 2. Or average inductor current minus delta I L closed by 2. So this is V naught duty cycle upon R 1 minus T whole square minus 1 by 2 Vs dt upon L. So this is the minimum average current, right? For the CCM mode, for the CCM mode, current, continuous current mode. For continuous current mode, now this I mean must be greater than or equal to 0. I mean must be greater than or equal to 0. That is substitute this value. That is V naught this is not V naught, this is the Vs supply voltage. So this is Vs duty cycle D R 1 minus D whole square minus 1 by 2 Vs duty cycle upon L is greater than or equal to 0. Greater than or equal to 0. When you solve this value, we will find now this L is greater than or equal to 1 minus duty cycle whole square into resistance into t upon 2. Now we know that t equals to 1 by f, where t is the total time, interval, where f is the choking frequency. Now is the choking frequency. Substituting this value, now this is greater than or equals to 1 minus dt cycle whole square r upon 2 into f, where f is the choking frequency. So there are condition. There is two condition. Either l is greater than this quantity or l is equal to this quantity. What is the minimum value of l? So minimum value of l, l min equals to 1 minus duty cycle whole square into load resistance upon 2 times of the choking frequency. So this value, this is the minimum value of inductance which are used at the design purpose. When you design the buck boost converter, you have to choose the inductance value is always greater than this quantity for the proper DC to DC conversion. Clear? Clear? This minimum value. Now come to the how to calculate the output repeat voltage. For the calculation of output repeat voltage, now we know that C equals to Q into B, or Q equals to CV, or Q equals to C into V, or delta Q equals to C into delta V, where delta Q is the differential charge. Differential charge and delta V is the voltage repeat. How to calculate now this differential charge? Now we know that now this delta Q equals to V naught by R into duty cycle into the total time period. R this is equals to C into delta V. Where delta V equals to delta Q upon C, or V naught by C into R duty cycle into the total time period, or this is equals to V naught into D upon C R F. Clear? So this is the voltage repeat, output voltage repeat. This is the output voltage repeat. Then how to calculate the repeat factor? Repeat factor, now we know that denoted by the gamma, where gamma equals to delta V naught upon V naught, where delta V naught is the voltage repeat factor upon the output voltage. This is equals to voltage repeat factor upon the output voltage. When you substitute here, you will get, now this is the V naught duty cycle upon C R choking frequency total divided by V naught. Now you will find duty cycle upon C R F. This is the gamma, I mean the repeat factor of the buck boost converter. Yeah? This is the refill factor of the buck boost converter. Clear? So this all parameter are related to buck boost converter. Basically this is the moderate type of DC to DC converter. If the load is not directly connected to source, then how to connect the load with the source? The load is connected in the two mode. When switch is closed, switch is on, now the energy is stored in the inductor. Clear? Then when switch is open circuit, the stored energy from the inductor is transferred to the load. Clear? तो आउटपुट और द आउटपुट ऑफ दिस बक बूस्ट कन्वर्टर इज डिपेंड अपॉन द ड्यूटी साइकिल. इफ ड्यूटी साइकिल इज ग्रेटर देन 50% द आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज ग्रेटर देन इनपुट वोल्टेज. इफ ड्यूटी साइकिल इज लेस देन 50% नाउ द आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज लेस देन द सोर्स वोल्टेज और इनपुट वोल्टेज. क्लियर. नाउ कम टू द कंट्रोल स्ट्रेटजीज फॉर द चॉपर्स. कंट्रोल स्ट्रेटजी फॉर द चॉपर. क्लियर. तो इन द तो देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ कंट्रोल स्ट्रेटजीज आर यूज्ड टू कंट्रोल द डीसी चॉपर. फर्स्ट है टाइम रेशियो कंट्रोल एंड सेकंड इज द करंट लिमिट कंट्रोल. क्लियर. इन टाइम रेशियो कंट्रोल देयर इज ड्यूटी साइकिल इज वेरीज. इन टाइम रेशियो कंट्रोल ड्यूटी साइकिल इज वेरीज व्हाइल इन द करंट लिमिट कंट्रोल द ड्यूटी साइकिल इज फिक्स्ड. क्लियर. तो बेसिकली यू कैन से हियर द करंट लिमिट कंट्रोल इज आल्सो द टू टाइप्स. तो दिस करंट लिमिट कंट्रोल इज टू टाइप्स. वन इज द कांस्टेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी सिस्टम. कांस्टेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल एंड अदर इज द वेरिएबल फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल. वेरिएबल फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल और वेरिएबल फ्रीक्वेंसी सिस्टम. तो इन कांस्टेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी सिस्टम हियर T R is because duty cycle is varying. Here, duty cycle is varies. Duty cycle where below that now this is the T on upon total time period. Total time period is fixed. Then how to vary the duty cycle if the T R is varies? T R is varies. Basically here T R is varies, but the chopping frequency because now this T is fixed. Total time period is fixed. Now this is equal to 1 by f. This is also a constant or fixed. So what parameter is varies? Only the t on time of the pulse is varying. Clear? So by varying the on time of the pulse, but keeping the chopping frequency is fixed, the variation of t on means the adjustment of the pulse width. Clear? Adjustment of the pulse width such as this scheme is also known as pulse width modulation. Clear? What is the pulse width modulation? Pulse width modulation is the type of analog modulation where the width of the pulses is varying according to instantaneous value of the input signal or instantaneous value of amplitude of the modulating signal. Clear? So this is the first case. Other is the time ratio control is also done with the variable frequency system. In variable frequency system, the chopping frequency is varying. Total chopping frequency is varying means total time period is varying. So how to total time period is varying? Either we can vary the on time of the pulse, total time period is varying, or by varying the half time of the pulse. In both the cases now total time period is varying. If total time period is varying means chopping frequency is varying. So by this way now we can control the chopper by two way. So this scheme in variable frequency scheme is also known as the frequency modulation. In frequency modulation, the frequency of the carrier signal, the frequency of the pulse signal is varying according to instantaneous value of the input signal or according to the instantaneous value of the amplitude of the modulating signal. Right? So these are the cases. Now, second case is the CLC, current limit control. In current limit control, the chopper is switched on and switched off periodically so that the load current is forced to remain between two predetermined limits. The small wind turbine, charging a battery bank are basically the type of control strategy for the control limit control. Right? Now, in next diagram you can see the graphical representation of the pulse width modulation. Pulse width modulation means this is the comparator where we put the actual amplitude and this is the desired amplitude. Now it compare. If the compared value is the positive, it gives the starting value. So this frame basically the width of the pulses is varying. Width of the pulses is varying means this type of the modulation is known as pulse width modulation. Right? And this is the graphical representation of the pulse width modulation because from here the duty cycle is 0.25. Duty cycle is fixed.
Clear? Then the duty cycle is fixed. Then how to vary? Total time is again fixed. So why varying this T on time? Clear? Now by varying the on time of the pulses, now we can vary the pulse width of the modulation. Here, keeping the duty cycle is fixed by 7. So how the chopping frequency? Duty cycle is fixed. Here the duty cycle is again fixed. In these cases, again the width of the pulses is varying. So this is the graphical representation of the pulse width modulation or the constant frequency method to control the DC to DC choppers. And this is the in frequency modulation, the fixed duty cycle, but varying the total time period. Now you can see this the for this 0.75 duty cycle, total time period this, for 0.25 total time period this. Again 0.25 total time period this, again 0.75 total time period this. This is a two method, either by control the on time of the pulses or by controlling the off time of the pulses. So these first two waveform is by controlling the on time of the pulses. These two are the controlling the TR. Controlling the TR, and these two graph is replaced the controlling the off time. Clear? In both the cases, now the total time period is varying. So this scheme is known as the frequency modulation or the frequency varying controlled of the choppers. So these are related to the buck boost converter and the control strategies of the chopper. Thank you. Now the chopper part is completed. And next lecture, I will discuss about the rectifier. Clear? In simple word, we can say rectifier is the AC to DC converter, but the exact definition of rectifier is it is an electronic device, an electrical device which converts bipolar signal into unipolar signal. Now other arrangement also required to convert the AC signal into the complete DC signal. Thank you.